I will literally fall out on the ground before I make two trips back down to get groceries out of the car. I will do one trip, even if it takes me out. And it really almost did. What a wonderful world. Let me back this up. You're like all up in my face. Welcome back to my channel, you guys. I didn't even say hi. Hey. So I have some really, really good news. I broke 500 subscribers today. Well, technically it was yesterday, but I'm just so happy about it. As you can see in my bio from the last like few videos, I've been saying like my short-term goal is 500 subscribers, and we have surpassed it. I'm at like 502. So thank you guys for subscribing and supporting me and just being a part of this journey with me. My next goal is 1,000 subscribers, so help me get there. Help me out, help your girl out. If you like my videos, just, you know, send them to people and share them and like them and comment and all that good stuff. So what I'm going to do to celebrate this milestone for myself is do a giveaway. So I'm giving away a $50 Amazon gift card, and it's really easy if you want to enter the giveaway. All you have to do is leave a comment below letting me know once you've completed this task, just saying done. And the task is just posting some type of screenshot of you or some type of picture. It can be like a video on your phone of you watching this video or any of my YouTube videos. It doesn't have to be this one, but any of my previous YouTube videos, and just mention me in it. I'm at Elise Live. And yeah, just like any screenshot or type of picture of you watching this video, and just give me a shout out on Instagram and give my channel a shout out and comment done below once you do that. And yeah, then you're officially entered into it. And then I'm gonna do like a little, I'm gonna randomize it and do a little shuffle. It'll be random, and I'll pick the winner, and you will get a $50 Amazon gift card. I'll email it to you. You can buy whatever you want on Amazon that's $50 or less. So, and that can go a long way on Amazon, okay? I've been getting a lot of stuff from there lately. But yeah, that is the giveaway. Thank you again for just being here and helping me reach my goal. So the next goal is 1,000. Now that we've got the giveaway and the rules out of the way, I wanted to do a get to know me video for people who may not know me, if you don't know anything about me. Usually people do this when they first start their channel, but now that we're here, I think this is a good point. The first question is, where are you from? I am from Michigan in the suburbs outside of Detroit, and born and raised there. I'm really proud of Michigan. If you have been keeping up with the news, you will know why. I'm proud of us. Anyway, that's where I'm from. I'm from Michigan. I go back a couple times a year. I live in LA right now, if you don't know. I live in Los Angeles, California, but I'm originally from Michigan in a small little town, a little bubble. I'll be going back for the holidays or for Christmas. What do you do for a living? I am a video editor. That's what I do. That's how I live out here in California. I have a job at a production company, and I edit videos. I run a lot of the social media. I just do kind of like a lot of creative stuff, and I really like it. I'm learning a lot. Somebody asked me in my last video, how are you able to afford living in LA, or what do you do? So that's what I do. That's what pays the bills, and it's totally remote right now. Eventually that'll change, but right now I just work from home, which is a really good setup for me. How tall are you? How tall would you guess I am before I say it? I mean, have I really, you would have no idea. Okay, so I'm 5'4". So I think that's considered like kind of average height. I used to be really short growing up. I was always like the shortest one. And now I'm just like, I feel like I'm average height, a little bit short, but yeah, I'm 5'4". Cats or dogs? Dogs for sure. He's been on the channel once, but I have a puppy named Charlie. He's actually in Michigan with my parents right now, because being a dog mom is no joke, okay? It's not a game. It's not for the faint of heart. It's hard, okay? And so I needed to give the puppy back to my parents just to, you know, kind of get my life together a little bit, just to take a breather. It's not easy. Don't let anybody fool you. Yes, puppies are cute, but it's hard. But yeah, I'm a dog person. I'm allergic to cats. I've never liked cats. They actually scare me. I think they're a little bit evil. I love dogs. I love dogs. I can speak dog. I'm obsessed with dogs. So yeah, it's not even close, not even a competition. Tea or coffee? Well, as you can see, you've probably seen it in my last videos, I like coffee and I like iced coffee. I make it a lot, well, like twice a week at home. But it's actually very hard because I like tea as well. If I could only drink tea or coffee for the rest of my life, I would have to go with coffee just because a couple times a week, it just tastes good. The way I make my coffee is really good. What is your favorite color? So my favorite color is like, you can kind of see it in the background. It's like this teal blue. It's not that top one. It's like that second one. Oh, that's so cool. I'm like pointing directly to it. I love this like teal type of color. And next to that, I go back and forth between that and yellow, because yellow is just like a happy, bright, beautiful color, and it just makes me happy. And so yeah, but if I had to choose one right now, it would be that like light blue teal color. It's just so pretty to me. Favorite drink? My favorite drink is LaCroix, or I don't know, people say LaCroix. I don't know what you want to call it. Boom, this. I drink them every day. I always have them in my fridge, and my sister Ashley and I were like, we don't feel right or at peace unless we have a fridge full of those, at least a whole case in our fridge. So we're completely obsessed. We love them. We love LaCroix. It's the best drink. Favorite worship song right now? That's so random, but it's not a new song, but I really love the song Yes and Amen, and Maverick City just covered it. I already like loved that song so much and just was like, you know, obsessed with that song because it's like, it's such a beautiful song. But there's a new cover of it, and Maverick City Music is one of my favorite like groups, and it's not the same group of people every time. It kind of varies with different gospel artists, but the way they come together, they just have this like unique sound that's like acoustic, but it's also like upbeat, and it's just beautiful. I love everything about it. And so yeah, Yes and Amen, so peaceful. It's so good. Chandler Moore is the lead singer for it, and his voice is just like amazing. Okay. What would you tell your younger self? Man, I mean, I didn't look at these questions ahead of time. I'm just kind of going off the cuff here. So, something I would tell my younger self is just to not stress and worry about things so much and just to enjoy life. I talked about this in one of my videos, I think 3 videos ago, how in my early 20s, and even for, I feel like, college and high school, I always was waiting for something to happen. I was waiting for, you know, some type of tangible thing to happen before I could be happy. I always said things like, oh, well, I need to make this amount of money in order to be happy. I need to have a boyfriend to be happy. I need to, you know, once I check this box, then I'll be happy. I was always delaying my happiness and waiting for something or someone else to bring it to me. And if I could tell something to my younger self, it would just to be, choose happiness in this moment with what you have, with where you are, with, you know, who's around you, and just what you've already been given. Just embrace it, be happy, be present, because, you know, that next thing that you think you want, you don't know that when or if it'll come. Honestly, so it's just like, why are you delaying happiness for this, you know, this variable that's unknown? So that's what I would tell my younger self, to just kind of like relax, not be so hard on myself. I've always been really hard on myself, and so just to, you know, just have more grace for yourself and where you are. And on top of that, just, you know, just stop being so daggone hard on yourself. Just stop stressing, stop worrying, just like choose happiness every day. And that's how I live my life now. I find so much joy in the small things and the simple things these days, like going to Home Goods and decorating my apartment and recording these YouTube videos. I just find so much joy in the little things. And in LA, it's actually very easy to do because I find a lot of joy in going to the beach. It's so simple, it's so easy, and it just makes me so happy. So yes, that is something I would tell my younger self, to just stop stressing and also to not care what people think. I think what's held me back from even putting out videos or content consistently is just wanting to be perfect all the time. And you know, honestly, if you look around a lot of these like influencers or people who are blowing up on TikTok, they're just deciding to show up and constantly put out things instead of waiting until everything's perfect, because that moment where you wait for everything to be perfect, things are just gonna pass you by. So yeah, that was a long answer to my question. I tend to get long-winded sometimes. What is your biggest accomplishment? My biggest accomplishment, and I talked about this, I have a whole video about this, was building a school in Kenya. That is something that I'm so, so proud of. It's probably one of the most impactful things I've done in my time here living on Earth, is providing education to children for years to come. It's going to be hundreds of children in Africa who otherwise wouldn't have had that opportunity to get access to education, and just what that will ultimately lead to. You never know. Education opens up so many doors. So just following through on that vision that God gave me and seeing it come to pass and going to see it in person, traveling to Kenya for myself, that is for sure the thing I'm the most proud of in my life. And I'm really glad that God really put that on my heart, and for so long for me to do that. So yeah, what's the first thing you do when you open your eyes in the morning? I wish this wasn't the case. I want to do better. The first thing I do is I check my phone. So I know a lot of the gurus and productivity gurus and people who promote mental health and things like that, they say for the first 2 hours of the day you shouldn't even check your phone. That's just not something I've been able to do. I literally pick up my phone and I check my messages, I check all the apps, and my church does a prayer call every morning, first thing in the morning. It's 5 a.m. Cali time, so 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And they do a prayer call, so I usually will wake up around like 5:15 and like catch the beginning of the prayer call. So that's the first thing I will do. But like I said, that's on Instagram. So the first thing I do is like pretty much go on Instagram, and I want to do better. I don't know. What do you guys think? Do you guys do that too? Is it just me? Like, I have the desire to do better, but yet that's the first thing I do. What kind of books do you like to read? So the books that I like to read are very like self-helpy type of books. Like, those are just my go-to books. I'm really into self-help books. 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, Think and Grow Rich, books that help with spirituality. Like, I love the book Fervent by Priscilla Shire. Like, and currently a book I'm reading is about relationships and marriage. It's called The Sacred Search. So I'm very, very into those inspirational, like self-help type of books. If you guys have any book recommendations, leave them down below, because I love reading books like that. Like those T.D. Jakes books, like Soar and Crushing. I think he's such a good author and he has a lot of good insight in his books. And I read a book by his daughter, Sarah Jakes Roberts, who's also a pastor. And so I read a lot of those self-help type of books. I don't do a whole lot of leisure reading. I read those books that you like take a highlighter and you try to implement them into your life, stuff like that. So very, very into self-help books. When was the last time you pushed yourself to your physical limits? It's usually when I'm carrying up all my groceries at once. I don't like to leave a single bag. That's honestly what it is. I remember a couple weeks ago, I carried like 8 grocery bags on one arm, like 9 on the other. And then what I normally do though is what my sister and I do, we take a empty suitcase, put it in the back seat of the car, put all the groceries in the suitcase, zip it up and just roll it upstairs. But sometimes I forget to put the suitcase in my car, or I'll just go to the grocery store randomly on the way home without planning it ahead. And so that's what I did a couple weeks ago. And I had so much stuff. I had like a case of water. I had so much stuff and I was by myself. And so I literally like, oh man, it was bad. It was so bad. I just like, I really, like by the time I got to the door, I had to just lay down and I didn't feel well because I tried so, like, I will literally fall out on the ground before I make two trips back down to get groceries out of the car. I will do one trip, even if it takes me out. And it really almost did those 2 weeks ago. But other than that, I thought of this time and like, I came to visit LA before I lived here. And I don't know if you guys have ever been to Venice Beach. There's like workout areas where they have like equipment. And this was like pre-COVID, so I would probably not do this at this point in time. But there's this rope that you could climb up. And I was really, I've always been like really competitive. Like I was that annoying person in gym class who was kind of like a show off growing up, who did like the most pull-ups and who did the most like climbed like up the rock climbing walls and stuff like that. I just was always really good at that stuff. And so I was in town for my friend's birthday a couple years ago, or like a year and a half, not even 2 years ago, it was like a year ago. And I saw that rope and I was like, you know what, I can climb that. I bet I can climb to the top. And it took so much out of me, but I'm gonna put the video up here. But I kept my face like that, I was like, you know, that I was good. Like I didn't let anybody see me sweat, but that really pushed me. And I think my arms were hurting for like 2 weeks after that because I hadn't pushed myself physically in that way in so long. What is your dream job? Well, I think at this point, my dream job is to fully embrace entrepreneurship and really just be my own boss, work for myself. But I guess another dream job I've always wanted is to be like a video producer or host for like a media outlet like Vox or Vice News or those kind of like newer platforms. I like how they kind of go past the traditional journalism of like, you know, local news, because I did that before. You might have watched one of my old videos where I quit my news reporter job because that's not the way traditional journalism doesn't really like speak to my career goals or what I want to do anymore. But that would be a really cool, that's something I would really want to do. Storytelling and the documentary storytelling they do, I really love that style. So that would be a dream job. But aside from like that type of stuff, like the journalism type of stuff, I want to be a singer like Ariana Grande, Whitney Houston. Like that is my dream job, to go on tour. That would be an absolute dream. I currently am taking vocal lessons right now, and so I don't know if I'll ever reach that goal, but that would be like an absolute, like if I could go back to when I was 3 years old, I would start doing singing lessons and Broadway eventually and music and really just, you know. But the thing is, like, I also don't feel like it's way too late now if I really focus. So who knows, you guys? I could still do that, maybe. That's really a dream job, though. That's why I'm taking vocal lessons right now. I want to be, and the thing is, I'm a very realistic person, too, even though I'm definitely a dreamer and a very passionate person. I also am realistic, and I know that I wasn't born with one of those natural, like, abilities to just blow, like some singers like JoJo and just people who can just like, their voice, it just makes you wanna just like throw your shoe at the screen or something like that. Or just, you know, it just, those voices that just give you chills. I unfortunately wasn't naturally given those vocal cords. So if I wanna get better, I'm gonna have to work a little bit harder. And you know what, I'm okay with that. I am making the investment to these vocal lessons. I've been committed, I've been practicing. So, you know, maybe in a year, my voice will be good enough to the point where I'll sing on this channel for you guys. That's all the questions. And I really like that we ended with that one because I wanna be honest and let you guys know that like my ultimate dream is to be a singer. That's, but even if I do sing, like lead worship, I used to do that a lot. That will genuinely make me happy. I'm so happy just singing in front of people and sharing my voice with people. So like, even if I never reach the level of Ariana Grande, I still will be satisfied just if I can regularly sing in front of people and get better. So yeah, I wanna know you guys' answers to some of these things. I definitely wanna know a dream job, because I talk about jobs and career on my channel pretty frequently. So let me know in the comments what your dream job is, what you wanna do. And also, don't forget to enter the giveaway so you can win $50 on Amazon and, you know, get whatever you want. The holidays are coming up. Maybe you can get a gift for somebody. I don't know. But share my channel. Help me reach 1,000 subscribers next. Thank you guys for being here. Thank you for watching. You guys are amazing. I love you, and I will see you in the next video. Bye, guys.